What's up guys, Techie Bird here today, and I'm going to be reviewing the Sony Xperia Play. Okay, it has a screen resolution of 480x854 TFT, the screen size is 4 inches, your average talk time will be about 8.5 hours, let's see. Standby time is about 425 hours, the talk time you'll get on 3G is 6.5 hours, and your standby time is 413 hours on 3G. It's packing Android 2.3 Gingerbread. It's running on a single core Scorpion ARM 1000 MHz. It also has 1/2 GB of RAM, 1/2 GB of ROM, 5 megapixel camera, LED flash. Its camera on the back records up to 1280x720, which is 720p HD. You can do video calling, and it's got a front facing camera, which is a VGA quality. It can hold up to 32 gigs of SD storage. And it has 400 megabytes of built-in memory. They put a 1500 milliamp hour battery, which is pretty good for a gaming phone. It's around more than 1/2 inch thick, which is a bit thick. And it weighs about 6.25 ounces. Ice cream sandwich comes out in a couple months. So this phone was made by Sony to show off Sony's PSP Go type controls. So people really didn't have to carry around a phone and a PSP. It would make it easier for them. Okay, so I want to go ahead and show you the gaming controls so you guys have a feel of how it would be. I'm going to go ahead and play Adrenaline 6 just a little bit and show you the controls. The controls are fairly easy if you've ever played any PSP type devices. It's got the standard pad right here. Analog sticks are touch sensitive. Your start, your select, X, circle, triangle, square, and your bumpers. Your volume control right there. Putting it out there, you guys don't have to use these. You could always play like this with the accelerometer. Controls are fairly easy to use. You can turn up their sensitivity or lower it. My hands are on the bigger side, so the controls are a little bit smaller and my hands get a little sore after a while. That could be the case for you guys, but remember, this is my user experience. It is not something that's going to happen all the time, because people have different hand sizes. Like I said, this had 1/2 GB of RAM and 1/2 GB of ROM. That's not bad, but considering this is a gaming phone, they should have put at least 1 GB of RAM in here. At least. They could put 768 megabytes, that would have been good. But 1 GB of RAM would have been perfect for it, since sometimes, you know, it freezes up. The boot up takes roughly 2 minutes. I tested that out, and that's quite slow compared to other phones. Okay, so I'm not going to bore you with the game anymore. One of the things that draws me towards Android from the iPhone is because you can have live wallpapers. Like here, let me go and show you. Wallpapers. Live wallpapers. And we're going to pick this one. Set wallpaper. And you can see that it moves around and you can actually play with the background a bit, which is quite fun if you don't have anything else to do. Overall, it's a great phone. It's got some drawbacks with the specs, but they tried their best and they didn't probably want to make it any bulkier or heavier. This was my review of the Sony Ericsson Xperia Play. Thanks for watching, guys.
I'll talk to you guys later.